Praise the Lord, God, been good. Amen. Thank God. Praise praise the Lord for all the word that came forth this week and just been feeding our soul. Amen. Glory be to God. Talking about holiness. Holiness is holiness of hell. Amen. Glory be to God. Holiness or hell. Glory be to God. We got to stick to holiness in our homes, in our churches. Glory be to God. We got to stick to holiness, don't we? Glory be to God. Without holiness, no man can see the Lord. Amen. Glory be to God. So we give God praise for that. Glory be to God. And we're looking forward to a great word tonight. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to God. Looking forward to the good preacher tonight. Praise God. Glory be to God. So we'll thank God for last night. Praise the Lord. Elder Roundtree, he was talking about that flesh. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God, we know we live after this flesh. We're going to die. Amen. We gonna die if we live after this flesh. But through the Spirit do modify the deeds of the flesh. Amen. Glory be to God. We shall live, don't we? Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to God. That means we got to subdue this flesh. We got to let go of the fleshly ways. Amen. Glory be to God. The carnal nature. God gave us a new nature. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. He raised us up from the dead. That sinful nature. Glory be to God. And now we got to take on that spiritual nature of God. Amen. God got to change our character. Glory be to God. He got to change our life. Amen. Glory be to God. And we can't let things creep in the church. Glory be to God. So this theme, praise the Lord, is very important. We need it, don't we? We need it. We see the time that we're living in today. So many people don't turn away from holiness. Those that used to live all through the years, glory be God, now they don't change to this modern day religion. Glory be to God. We got to pray. We got to pray that God keep us in holiness. Amen? There's no new way. Amen? But it's God's way. I said it's God's way. Hallelujah, Jesus. So we got to walk in the ways of holiness. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, we'll be right back. Lord. We thank God. Praise the Lord, everyone being here tonight. Now it's time for the word of God. Amen. Glory be to God. So put your hands together. Glory be to God for the man of God. From Nassau, Bahamas. Amen. Glory be to God here to preach the word of God. Amen. Through trials and tribulation, God has brought him through. Amen. So we thank God. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. We looking for God to use him tonight. Amen. Glory to God. So open up your heart and your mind. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. And put your hands together one more time for Bishop Deon.
Come on, somebody give the Lord a praise.
Now thank you, Father, for what you are doing and about to do. By your name, Jesus, we give praise. Everybody clap your hands and say amen. Amen. God bless everybody. God bless you. Let me see it. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Like I said, today that the Lord has made. And we has rejoiced and very glad to be in the land of the living. We do honor the presence of the Lord Jesus, the one that brought this together, made it possible that we should be here. Thank God for our presiding Apostle Marvin Smith. Somebody bless the Lord. Of course, we thank God for our beloved Bishop Leonard Williams. God bless you, sir. We love you tonight. You're looking so young. Amen. You need to give these children some fountain of your water. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank God for, amen, Minister Richardson tonight. God bless you. Amen. Thank God for Minister Williams tonight. Amen. God bless you. Thank God for Minister Bishop Moss. Clap your hands for him. Thank God for Minister. Amen. Hallelujah. God, you flowers. Amen. Praise God. I'm looking over the congregation. I see all of you tonight. Time does not permit me, but give yourselves a round of applause to be here. God bless all of you tonight. Amen. Amen. Conventions are always a wonderful time. Amen. Praise God, because we put on our best and we put on our best faces. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. We came in from far and near. Amen. Some of you came from Wilson, North Carolina. 10 hours drive, I understood. Hallelujah. On a good day, you can drive around Nassau City in half an hour, am I right? On a good day. On a Sunday, you can actually cover the whole circumference of Nassau Island in half an hour. Amen. Hallelujah. But once somebody said it's the place where God lives, come on, somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. We live there. People pay to come there. Amen. So we are so grateful tonight to come all the way from Nassau to be with you. Amen. We look forward to these times because, praise the Lord, these are times that are special to us. Praise the Lord. Amen. Had it not been for the reason of death, many others would have been here. Hallelujah. I believe, amen, Brother Hamilton would have been here. Somebody bless the Lord tonight. Amen. I believe Apostle J.B. Sands, the late Apostle J.B. Sands, would have been right here. Come on, somebody. Amen. One brother said, one more time. One more time. You allow us to come together. One more time. Hallelujah. So we cannot take these moments for granted. And our friendship and relationship with each other for granted, because we don't know. We just don't know. But the Bible put it this way: be also ready. And so, praise the Lord. We thank God. Yes, my friend, Sister Hicks would have been here. Yeah. Sister Hicks would have been here. Amen. Stay right somewhere there. Amen. God bless you tonight. I am so honored and favored that the Lord has looked upon me and allowed me to come even year by year and to be chosen as one of your speakers on this occasion. I pray God tonight that a word will come forth that will stir you. Amen. You leave this place, hallelujah, with a zeal and a fire burning down in the bottom of your souls. Somebody shout amen. Amen. What a theme we have for this week. What a theme we have for this week. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. A highway.
called holiness. Hallelujah. A highway called holiness. And not everyone will travel this highway. This highway is for the true church. For those who are called to that great city, that celestial shore, that place where we all desire that we should gather. So this assembling here tonight may be nice, but won't it be better if we all can gather over yonder? What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see. I will look upon his face. I want to behold him for myself. That's what Job said, right? Job said, I know that my Redeemer liveth. He shall stand in the earth after that day. Though after my skin were in my flesh, or in my body, yet in my flesh I shall see God. I shall behold him for myself. Hallelujah. We may not understand everything now, but we will understand it better by and by. If anybody in here have that hope, have this hope, throw your hands in the air and give Jesus a praise in this house. A highway that is called holiness. A highway that is called holiness. Hallelujah. What a thing. Conventions are times when we come together and we really look back in retrospect and give God thanks for all he has done. Somebody said, if it had not been the Lord on our side, look at what the hell you've been through in 2023. But tell somebody you made it. You made it, man. You made it. I made it. Amen. 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 They said you wouldn't be here today. Amen. Look at you. Amen. You're still holding on. Amen. Somebody give God a praise. But it's more than just to reflect in retrospect on what we had came through and what brought us here. But it's also a time to look forward. Because convention only comes once a year. Yeah. So it's a time to look forward. Amen. And the jaw of the prelate, the chief shepherd, and the shepherd among us, is to cast a vision. Yes. Cast a vision. Write the vision. Make it plain. Lord have mercy in here. Hallelujah. And the theme for the convention is not only for this time of gathering, but it's a time for the whole year. So for this year, we should aspire to travel that highway. That way that is called holiness. Holiness. So this theme is not just a statement that we are making, but this theme is a clarion call for the church wake up. Shake yourself. Arise, O thou sleeper. Arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light. This is a call. See, because the church now has come to a very important time of its existence. We have come to a time when God is calling his people and the church to be the church. Having a name, carrying a title, having words of testimony is all good. But it's now time for the people of God to rise up. Hallelujah. And be the people in the earth that God has called us to be. We are more than just an organization. The Bible said that we are the body of Christ. And God wants to glorify himself in the earth. And so, if God would be glorified in the earth, hallelujah, the world needs to see the glory and the image of God in the face and in the lives of his people. A call. Holiness. What's a highly? It amazed me. I'm very much amazed at the road network in these United States. It's amazing, ain't it? It's amazing. Hallelujah. But what we do understand that the major interstate highway makes traveling easier. You ain't gonna say nothing. If Wilson had to go through the towns and the cities to get here, Wilson would have still been on the highway trying to get here. And when they arrived, we would have been saying amen. Because you just reached too late. But the highway is designed, those interstate highways is designed to make your travel easier. A lot of people see those highways and they want to just jump on the highway. No, there's rules that governs the highway. You got to know the rules. You got to know how to drive on those highways. Unless you want us to bring you in the church and take you to the nearest burying place. You don't play on those highways. You don't play. I was driving along today and we were in that, what was that lane that has the HOV? What that mean? I guess all of us have stuck with that. HOV. I like to go in the fast lane. Minister Flowers says, Bishop Mott, you like fast cars. You like fast cars. I love fast cars. Come on, say amen. Minister Bishop Moss love BMW. I said, Bishop Moss, that's too much exposure for me. I love not small cars, you know, something that is not so obvious. Come on and say amen. Amen. But somebody driving on the faster lanes, I think that's the lane far left. And he on the phone.
Yes.
He got a long line of cars. And he just chatting along. And every opportunity you see a car swing out and go around and swing out, go around. I said, let me swing out and go around too. You have to know how to drive on this highway. You don't use your phone. You could imagine you going 70, 80 miles an hour. And you're on the telephone, being in a conversation. to know, see, and then the thing about the sad thing about it, Bishop Williams, is that people don't hurt themselves, they hurt other people. They are danger to the person next to them. And you got to know how to maneuver on these highways. The Bible said, or the thing said, a highway is designed to take you from one destination to another in a more safer and more smooth route. Hello, somebody. But you guys don't come on this highway. There are rules. See? A lot of people can play the game, but they cannot play by the rules. You can put that ball in the net as a basketball player, but you only got 5 fouls. Then you finish. You can't play no more. There's a lot of people cannot play within the boundary.
Make it plain.
They cannot play by the rules. If you're coming on this highway of holiness, there are rules you got to follow. Lord have mercy. You gotta get back to the Word of God. The Word of God is our code of conduct. We gotta live by the code of God's Word. Listen to this. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians chapter number 6 and verse number 9. See, the highway is taking us to a destination. What is that destination? Heaven. The kingdom of God. That's where we are traveling. See, this life, this Christian life you're living is not just to live. But you're living to live again. You're living to live forever. You're living to conquer death, hell, and the grave. Verse 9. Know ye not that no unrighteous, or not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? See? There's some things you gotta know before they give you a license to drive. They have to make sure you understand the rules. And so the Bible said, the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Be not deceived. Neither fornicators. Oh Lord, have mercy. No idolaters, no adulterers, no effeminate, no abusers of themselves with mankind, no thieves, no covetous, no drunkards, no revilers, no extortioners, no extortionist shall inherit the kingdom of God. See? So you gotta live by the rules. If you go in there and the highway that you're traveling is the highway of holiness, you gotta learn the rules. You gotta be holy. Question is, listen to verse 11. And such were some of you. You've been there. You've done that. Now he has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. Hello, somebody. Watch this. But Yeah, wash. If you wash, don't go back. Don't go back and defile yourself. Don't be like a dog going back to its own vomit. But you wash. You wash. God said, I have made you clean. And I have prepared you to travel on this highway. Thank you, Holy Ghost. But you are sanctified. Sanctify means you are set apart. Christians today got to understand they are just no common, ordinary folk. God said, I've called you out from among them. I've called you out of your sins. I've called you out of darkness. I've called you out of the world. Thank you, Jesus. Come out from among them. Why? Because you've been called to holiness. Holiness is within and without. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in what? In heaven. How are men going to know that you have a light if you don't let it shine? Because no man take a candle and light it and put it under a bushel. You are a city set on a hill that cannot be hid. God don't have no secret disciple. God don't have no secret disciple. Peter tried to hide and to cover himself, but he couldn't because his speech gave him away. They know who you are. You can't fake it to make it. You might as well be real, because the devil know who you are, and folks around you know who you are. Lord, have mercy. Help me tonight, Lord. But you're sanctified, but you are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Highway. If you own this highway, you gotta play by the rules. You gotta govern your life by the rules. Hallelujah. And the good thing about it is, if the Bible said, amen, if any man sin, help me somebody. See, if any man sin, God know that there are times we all may stumble and fall. Whether by word, by deeds, by thoughts, he know. Because we don't fight against flesh and blood. We fight against principalities and powers. Hello, somebody. We fight against the rulers of the darkness of this world. Am I talking to anybody here tonight? Spiritual wickedness in high places. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So, he said here, amen. He said in 1 John chapter 1. In verse 8, come on. 1 John chapter 8 in verse, for chapter 1 and verse 8. If we say that we have no sin. See? Oh my folks acting crazy and all of that. We all have sin. And come short of the glory of God. So you might as well be real with it and enjoy your night. It's me, oh Lord. Standing in the need of prayer. See, let me tell you something. Anytime I think, I pray for me. Pray for Bishop Mott. Last night I seen a body walk come for prayer. I said, let me come for prayer. Let me come for prayer. I need prayer. Preacher, pray for me. You see, it doesn't matter what you think. I tried to make my calling an election show. I tried to make it in. Come on and say amen. So if we say we have no sin, we do what? You deceive yourself. Deceive not your own self. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord have mercy. You may lie to others, but it's a bad thing when you're going to lie to yourself. You're going to lie to yourself? Somebody needs to say amen. He said, and the truth is not in you. But look at verse 9. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just. He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Somebody need to say amen.
Amen.
So, you got to live by the word of God. You got to live by the word of God. Go with me to the book of Genesis chapter 28. Go with me to Genesis chapter 28. I'm getting there. I'm taking you somewhere. I'm taking you somewhere. Verse 12 and 13 says, and he dreamed. This is Jacob now. This is Jacob. He had a dream. And behold, a ladder was set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to where? Heaven. This ladder is symbolic and a representation of the highway. Because the ladder reaches from earth to glory. And so, if you get on the ladder, you're on the highway. See, and every step take you what? Higher. Every step draw you closer. You all seeing this? So Jacob saw this ladder. And the Bible said the top of it reached to heaven. And behold, the angels of God ascending. Ascending means going up. And descending, coming down on it. Amen. Why could the angel travel on this highway? Because they're traveling in the realm of holiness. See? So you and I are traveling on this ladder. We climbing this ladder. We climbing this ladder. Come on and say amen. What's it now? Look at verse 13 is where I want to take you. And behold, the Lord stood above it. You see that? You see that?
Yes,
so, we're traveling on this ladder. We're traveling on this highway. And who's at the end of the highway? Who's at the end of the ladder? Jesus. Nobody say nothing. Jesus is at the top of the ladder. Oh, glory be to God. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham, thy father, and the God of Isaac, and the land beyond thou liest to thee, will I give it to thy seed. Watch it. John chapter 14. Follow me. John chapter 14. Look at verse 6. Jesus said unto him, I am the way. See it? We come full circle. I am the way. I am the way. Amen. Praise God. The team said, a highway. Jesus is saying, I am the highway. I am the way. I need a church in here. I am the truth. I am the light. Somebody say glory. If you don't get on this highway, you got to get in Jesus. If you're going to travel this highway, you got to travel in Jesus. Somebody say yes. Yes, Lord. Can I tell somebody tonight? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Jesus is your everything. I said, Jesus is your everything. He's everything you need. Somebody say yes. Come on and tell him yes. I said, Jesus.
is everything I need. Somebody say yes. Yes, Jesus. He is the Alpha. He is the Omega. Yeah, he is your everything. He is your strength. Somebody say yes. Every language has its own alphabet. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. I said every alphabet, every language has its own alphabet so that they can form words. Somebody say glory. In the English language, we have the A to Z. I need a church in here. Jesus said, I'm the beginning and I am the end. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. If I was calling upon A, it was said he's the Alpha. Somebody say glory. And he's amen. I'm before everything. And neither shall there be any after me. If I call upon B, God will testify. Jesus said he is the bright and the morning star. Somebody say yes. Somebody tell him yes. If I call upon C, Jesus said he's the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. Jesus said he's the bright and morning star. He's the day star. Jesus said he is everlasting life. Ever say he is the first and he is the last. Jesus said he's the good shepherd. Can I get somebody in here and call Jesus? He's your everything. Somebody call Jesus. He's your everything. Somebody call Jesus. Jesus say he's the good shepherd. Age will say he's high and lifted up. I will say he is immortal. J will say he is the joy of my salvation. K will say he is the King of Kings. Somebody better bless him in here. L will say he's the Lord of Lords. M will say he's my Messiah. I need somebody to get him glory. M will say he is ever near me. O will say he is omnipotent. He is omniscient. He is omnipresent. P will say he is the Prince of Peace. Q will say he is the quickening power. Somebody give him glory. I will say he is my rock in the very land. A shelter. Somebody bless him here in a time of storm. Somebody say yes. He's the true wine. I said he's the true wine. I'm not talking about that intoxicated vine. I'm not talking about that fermented vine. I need somebody here. He said, be not drunk with wine, but be filled with the Holy Ghost. Somebody say glory. Mary, his mother, came to him. And he said, they have no more wine. He said, woman, my hour is not yet come. Somebody bless him. Somebody give him glory. Somebody give him praise. He's the true wine. Somebody say amen. You will say he's unchanging. He's unchanging. The same yesterday, the same today, the same forever. Could I tell somebody, the same God that walked with Moses is the same God that walked with Jesus, the same God that walked with Paul is the same God that's walking with us. Somebody say amen. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. Come on, tell me. Away. He washed my sins
noise away. Oh my God. I said, oh my God. What a wonderful, marvelous day. A God looked down from heaven and looked upon me and made me a part of his family. God is saying that. And then he gave me his name. He gave me his name. Y'all ain't saying that. Hallelujah. X is expectation. Expectation. Anybody have any expectation in him? Anybody anticipating God to move? Any faith walkers in here? Any faith walkers in this house? Glory be to God. I'm living by expectation. He made me a promise. I wouldn't take it back. Somebody shout glory. Somebody shout glory. Why said his yoke is easy? His yoke is easy. Don't cast your burden on me. I may be with you for 1 or 2 days, but the third day I can get tired of you. The third day I can tell you need to go away. You can't be laying up in my bed eating my food and throwing your foot up watching my TV. Go away. But his yoke is easy. His burden is light. And then Z said, he is the Zion that is to come. He's Zion. He didn't mention Z because V means victory. I need somebody to help me. V means victory. Victory over sin. Victory over hell. Victory over the grave. See, the Christians gotta understand this thing. We gotta understand what Jesus did for us. We said he died. And he forgave our sins. Yes, you are true. But that's only part of the story. Hallelujah. That's only part of the story. Not only did he die, but he gave you the victory over life. He gave you victory over sickness. He gave you victory over disease. He gave you victory over poverty. He gave you victory over all of your temptations. He gave you victory over all of your struggles. I'm here to tell somebody, you got the victory. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. I'm here to tell you, this is not the end of the story. This is the beginning. Because the Bible said, and then praise God, I don't want you to weep like the world weep. I don't want you to be sorrowful like the world are sorrowful. Somebody say glory. If those that are dying, dying in the Lord, I'm here to tell them, and then they will sleep. And one day God is going to bring us together. For the Bible said, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trump shall sound, and the dead in Christ is going to rise first, and we that are alive and redeemed shall be caught up. before the rapture, absent from the body, present with the Lord, live with expectation. Look at your trouble. Say, trouble don't last always. This too gonna pass. This too gonna pass. Whatever you're going through, whatever you're experiencing, whatever you're facing, can I tell somebody, it's not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, said the Lord. Mountain, I say unto you, the people of God, be coming forward. I hear the Lord say unto his disciples, loose the man and let it go. Enough to stop you, enough to hold you down, enough to bind you, because Jesus said, whom the Son has set free is free indeed. Somebody throw your hands in the air.
He said, they see, but they don't see. They hear, but they don't understand and perceive what they hear. When you read the word of God, that's God talking to you face to face. He spoke with Moses as a man talking with his friend face to face. God want to speak to you face to face. You don't need an apostle. You don't need a prophet. The Bible said these will come. I give these gifts. Apostle, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teacher. Amen. Glory to God. As gifts into the church so that they can perfect your faith. Somebody need to say glory. Amen. Praise be the name of the Lord. Amen. So when you need a word from the Lord, amen, go to the book. Somebody say glory. And God himself, I say God himself, he's not going to send Michael. Hey, he's not going to send Gabriel like he sent Gabriel to Mary and he sent Gabriel to Elizabeth. But the Lord himself, I say the Lord himself. Can I get a church in here? I say the Lord himself. God want to meet you face to face. God want to talk to you face to face. Anybody in here want to see the master? Somebody say glory. Turn your face. Oh my God. In the book and the Bible said the Lord himself will come. Somebody say glory.
Lift your hands to this place. Lift your hands. Do you know who you are? Do you know who you are? You are a child of the King. We say those words
But do we understand what that means? You have to convince yourself.
Yes. That's it.
Yeah. Persuade yourself. Yeah. Work on your own weak mind.
Yes.
That is impossible for God to lie. Every word he said, he stands by it. If he said, by my strength, ye are healed, then you apply that word to the word of God, the word of God over that situation and believe God. Everything don't happen overnight. What are you saying to them? Jesus healed blind man's eye. When Bartimaeus called upon him, he didn't even touch Bartimaeus. He said, receive your sight. And then there was another blind man in the scriptures where Jesus spat on the ground and made clay and put it over his eyes. And he asked, do you see clearly? He said, I see men as trees walking. Jesus touched him again. And it came to pass. God is saying that some things don't happen overnight. That's why the scripture said we don't walk by sight. Once you bring that situation to God, you start thanking him for it. And then there are times when he may not come when you want him to come or need him to come. You think, And so you may think in your mind, God will hear you. He heard you. All you need to do is bring his word back to his remembrance. See, a lot of people don't know what prayer is. Prayer is simply calling God to his word. Calling God to his word. This is what you said. Bring it to him. He got to honor his word. And he will come. He will not fail. He will come in a time appointed. And he will not fail. God is able to save to the utmost. Somebody give God praise right there. God bless you. Feel the warmth in your hands. Save to the utmost.
Yes.
Those baby children, bring them to the altar. Don't you say nothing.
Amen.
That financial crisis, bring it to the altar. Don't you say nothing. Throw your hands in the air and show God I believe. I pray tonight that the Lord will help your unbelief. And you will lay a hold upon the word of God. Like Jacob held on to the angel or to the man that he fought. Shadabahosa, Rebe Shabrasta. And you will cry out like Jacob, I will not let this word go until I see the manifestation come to pass. Somebody say, Lord, I believe. Whatever crisis you face right now, whatever situation, whatever mountain, whatever mountain that stands before you tonight, I, as the representative of the Lord Jesus Christ, speak to that mountain, and I say, mountain, be thou removed. Said, if you have faith as big as a grain of mustard seed, you will say unto this mountain, what mountain you face tonight, I say to the mountain, be thou.